Hello sustainable growers, welcome in this video. Today we're going to talk about water consumption in aquaponics. So we always say that aquaponics is consuming 10 times less water than a classic garden, and this is quite true, but what is important to understand is where does this consumption come from? Because in a classic garden we consume some water because we water the soil, and 90% of the water is just falling into the ground. It's not absorbed by the plant. The plant absorbs a very, very minor quantity of this water that we use. In aquaponics, we put the water in the system, but we are in a closed environment, in a closed ecosystem. So the water stays in the system, right? It circulates, it goes to the fish tank, from the fish tank to the grow bed, and back into the fish tank. So we could think, okay, the water is trapped in the system, and we don't consume any water. Well, today we're going to talk about the different points where we consume water in aquaponics. So the first thing to understand is that when we grow fish and when we grow vegetables, inside the body of those fish, inside the body of those vegetables, we got some water. A fish, for example, is 75 to 83% of water, right? The rest, you got only like 16-17% of dry matter, and the rest is water. So you understand that each time you produce a fish and you harvest a fish, you basically harvest water from your aquaponic system. But the fish side is one thing, but you know that in aquaponics we produce approximately 10 times more biomass of vegetables than fish. Those vegetables that you produce, when you harvest them, you harvest also a lot of water away from the system. So that's exactly what happened in aquaponics. Every time you harvest something from the system, or every time the vegetables are growing, they just get some water out of the system. So that's the first place where you consume some water, is into the fish and into the vegetables. The second point is into the evaporation. So we got some evaporation that is happening in aquaponics, and we're going to talk about it today. The first thing is obviously in the fish tank. So in the fish tank you got a lot of water, volume of water, and this water is in contact with the atmosphere. And at this point obviously you got some water that is, depending on the concentration of moisture you got in the atmosphere, the water is going to evaporate to basically release some oxygen and some hydrogen that is into the water. So the water is evaporating, and when the water is evaporated, you lose some water from your aquaponic system. Now, if you got a fish tank, you know that we normally cover the top of the fish tank because of the sunlight, because we don't want to have too many algae that grow in the fish tank. So depending how you do that, sometimes we can cover part of the fish tank, sometimes a bit more. But what happens is it kind of traps a bit of air on the top of the fish tank, and this air is full of moisture, is 100%, we call it saturated with moisture. So when you are 100% saturation, the evaporation is limited, which means that that's a really good way to limit the quantity of water that you consume, is to basically partially cover the fish tank. In the grow bed, that's the same thing. We got 3 centimeters on the top of the grow bed that are dry, right? 3 centimeters of media. And underneath you got your water variation. So here, the 3 centimeters of the top, between the rocks, you're gonna have the air that is kind of trapped. It's not completely trapped, right? But you're gonna have this air that is remaining here. And what happened is that this air is gonna be saturated with moisture as well. So it kind of limits as well the evaporation. But where you got a lot of evaporation in a grow bed is through the leaves of the vegetables. You know that the leaves here, they basically, when there is a bit of wind, they evaporate the water. You know that on the leaves of the vegetables, you got some little holes that we call stomata, and from there is some evaporation. So they release some water, and because there is some evaporation, it helps the rest of the energy to raise into the plants. So you lose a significant quantity of water through the vegetables, but that's fine. I mean, it happens exactly the same thing in a normal garden, right? So we have some water that is lost here through the vegetables, but you can minimize this quantity. So understand that the evaporation happens at any time, right? But there are two factors that are increasing this evaporation. The first one is the quantity of sun. If it's very hot, obviously you're going to have more evaporation from the leaves, which is okay because we need a lot of sun for our plants to grow, right? So sun is a good point. But there is another factor, which is the wind. If it's very windy, you're going to have a lot of evaporation. But the wind is not really a positive thing for our aquaponics garden. A bit of wind can be necessary for the fertilization of some plants, such as the tomato, you know, for the fertilization of the flower, to turn the flower into a fruit. But then for the rest, we don't want too much wind on the leaves, otherwise it's going to break the leaves and it's going to increase the evaporation. So depending where you put your setup, if you put your setup in an area where there is not too much wind, against a wall, for example, that is stopping the wind, you're going to limit the water consumption of your system. If you expose your system at full wind, then the water consumption is going to increase. Another type of consumption is when basically you got your system that is not well balanced. If you got, for example, not enough vegetables in your system is going to produce a lot of nitrogen, a lot of nutrients. But if you don't have enough vegetables, not enough plants, the plants are not going to absorb all this nitrogen that is created. And therefore, the nitrogen, for example, the nitrate, is going to increase into your water. And every day it's going to increase a little bit. But after a while, you need to decrease this level. You can't leave this level increasing. Otherwise, it's become toxic for the fish. So if your system is well balanced, you don't have to do that. But if you don't have enough plants, sometimes you need to take some water and to use it to water your classic garden. In this case, what you have to do is to add new water. And when you add new water, you basically dilute the concentration of nitrate. So you can see here that we got a consumption of water, but actually this water is used for something else. We use it as a fertilizer for the normal garden. So it's not a real consumption. It's not a waste, let's say, but we still need to add new water. So we need to take it in account if we want to be totally fair. So now we understand where the water is going. We understand where we lose water in aquaponics, but how to top up the system. You understand we are in a closed ecosystem, so if we lose a bit of water, the water level into our system is going to decrease, especially if you go to a sump tank or a fish tank, you're going to see that the level water is going to decrease. And sometimes you need to add new water, right? But don't wait too much. My recommendation is to not wait to have 50% of the water gone to put 50% at once. What the fish and the bacteria don't like is the variation of parameters in your water. You know, they don't like if there is variation into the pH of the water, into the temperature, into the concentration of chemicals, all those type of things. So what you want is to minimize the shock. And what you can do is to add some water, new water in your setup when you see 10% of the water that has disappeared. So if you see that your system has decreased, the level of the system has decreased by 10%, that's the best time to add new water in the system. When you do that, basically the new water that is coming is going to have a different profile as the water that is currently in the system. But because it's only 10%, it's going to be diluted and the fish are not even going to feel it. While if you do it when it's 50% of water, if you add 50% at once, then it's going to be a big shock for your fish and for your bacteria. It's not going to be good. So the trick is really to renew the water, to add a bit more water as often as possible, as soon as you reach 10% of the total volume. I hope this video is helpful for you. If you are new to aquaponics, don't forget to get the free guide from the description just below. It's a 6-step guide that is going to help you to build your own aquaponics setup and to understand the limits and the different ratio to respect in aquaponics. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and you're going to receive all the new videos, all the new tips that I give every week. And if you finally enjoy the video, please give it a like. See you in the next one. Bye-bye. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!